Hi everyone! Welcome to Souped Up Recipes. Today, we're making chicken and broccoli. This is a super healthy dish and it's so easy to make. Let's get right into it. I am using a large piece of chicken breast. It is about 11 ounces. Cut it in half. I like to slice it with an angle because I think this is good for the marinade. Add 1 tablespoon of soy sauce, 1 tablespoon of water, half of an egg white, 2 tablespoons of cornstarch. Mix that up. After you make sure that every piece of chicken is coated nicely, you still want to keep massaging it for another 5 minutes until you can feel that the chicken has a velvety texture. Cornstarch and egg white will give a lot of moisture to the chicken and create a starchy layer to lock the juiciness inside the meat. That is the key to a tender, juicy meat. Okay. Let us sit for about 20 minutes and we'll make a sauce. In a small bowl, add 2 teaspoons of cornstarch, 1/2 teaspoon of white pepper, you can also use black pepper here, 2 tablespoons of soy sauce, 1 tablespoon of oyster sauce, 1 tablespoon of brown sugar, 1 teaspoon of grated ginger, 1 teaspoon of grated garlic, 1/2 cups of chicken stock. Give that a mix. I also add a teaspoon of dark soy sauce so the color looks nicer. Okay, set the sauce aside and let's prepare our vegetables. Of course, you will need some broccolis. I cut them into bite size. Besides that, I also use some thin slices of carrot to give the dish some bright color. Next, we will toast the vegetables in a pan. Heat the pan really hot, then you can add your broccoli and the carrot as well. I am just turning the cut surface face to the pan and wait for it to change color. In about 2 minutes, you can give it a little peek. If you see the color is nice, like this one, flip them all over and sear the other side. What I am looking for is sort of like roasted broccoli. Trust me, this is going to taste really good. I actually learned this from a Thai cooking channel called Hot Thai Kitchen. She makes amazing Thai food and she's always so kind and detailed about every recipe she made. If you love Thai food, you should go check out her channel. The broccoli and the carrot are looking good. Let's set that aside and move on to the chicken. Turn the gas to the maximum. I am adding about 2 tablespoons of oil. Wait until the oil is hot. Then add your chicken. Separate then. Make sure every piece of chicken touches the bottom directly. Wait for 1 minute or two and you can check the color. If you see it is nice and brown on the bottom, then flip all the chicken over, fry the other side. When both sides have nice color, that is what we are looking for. You can add the broccoli back to the wok. Give that a toss, then pour in that delicious sauce. Toss everything together and taste it to see if you need more salt. Mine was just perfect. Also, you should check the consistency of the sauce. When you see every piece of chicken and broccoli are coated nicely and the sauce is slightly thick, you can take it out. This is a flavorful dish so it is good to just serve it with white rice. Let's give it a try. To me, the broccoli has a lot of flavors. It's a little bit smoky because we roasted, and it's still got that crunchy bite. It's very good. Let's try the chicken. The chicken tastes good. It's like you're eating a piece of roasted chicken meat. Remember how we pan fry it? Both sides get that nice golden brown color. And inside, it's super tender because the way how we marinate the chicken. Also, look at this savory sauce. It is perfect to go with white rice. You have to try this. As always, you can check the description for all the ingredient amounts. And please give me a thumbs up. If you like Chinese food, please subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any episode. If you want to know more about me or support me, check out my Patreon link. It's right there. And I'll see you next time. Bye.